Good afternoon. Will everyone please stand for the playing of our national anthem?
Could have went a little sooner. It worked though.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in. Star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
You may be seated. On behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to welcome you to our graduation ceremony. We are excited that we can have it in person this year with so many friends and family around. At this time, I would like to introduce the Clintonville School Board members who are able to join us. President Ben Huber, Vice President Chadwick Dobie, Larry Zarnecki, Chris Strawman, Mark Zacco, Lori Volrath, and Glenn Luntz. I would also like to welcome current superintendent, Mr. Troy Kuhn, high school principal, Mrs. Kelly Zeinert, and associate principal, Mr. Brett Strahoda. Now that we have introductions completed, let's get started with the rest of the ceremony. The CHS choir will now sing, "I've Had the Time of My Life."
Time of my life, no, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's the truth, and I owe it all to you. Yes, I swear.
body and my soul, I want you more than you'll ever know.
So we'll just let it go, don't be afraid to lose control.
Yes, I know what's on your mind when you say, stay with me tonight.
Stay with me,
just remember.
Joseph Klemp, who will share with us his co-valedictorian address.
Welcome parents, teachers, administrators, guests in the graduating class of 2022. It is my honor to formally announce that we survived four mostly consecutive years of unplanned fire drills, diamond scream talking, cat shirt Wednesdays, and late bus announcements on days that should have been snow days. But seriously, we are here today because we made it. Though graduating from high school is one of the bare minimum requirements society and Officer Bartel ask of us, doing so is no easy task. It's obvious that all of you put the extra effort in to hear my lovely voice and to get the once-in-a-lifetime chance to shake Kelly Zeinert's hand. It seems like just yesterday we were nervously walking into these gym doors during freshman orientation on the first day of high school. And now we are sitting here, cap and gown in hand, fully prepared to plunge straight into our future educations, careers, lives, relationships, financial statuses, and over-the-hill birthdays and retirements. Make that mostly prepared. Let's be honest, as nice as it feels to have the next 5 or 40 years of our lives planned, it's both equally terrifying and exciting to have no idea what the future holds. Before we get too sentimental, I'd like to cover some bases first. Hi, my name is Joe Klemp, and I will be speaking on behalf of the class of 2022 and the many great things we are bound to accomplish. I apologize in advance if I sound a little hoarse. My sister Kayla somehow talked me into running a half marathon this morning. So before I tip over, I'd like to take a moment to thank the people who helped me get to where I'm standing today. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for being there and encouraging me these past 4 years. Whether it's the life coach advice or the simple questions like, how was your day? I honestly don't know where I'd be without you both. Thank you to my sister Beth for stressing the importance of extracurriculars and connecting with me when school got overwhelming. Kayla, thank you for teaching me efficient ways to study, drawing me a map of the high school so I wouldn't get lost, and lastly, turning the title of valedictorian into a familial competition. I'd also like to thank the many innovative teachers who not only taught us, but simultaneously tolerated us for the entirety of our high school careers. Let's give them a round of applause. And as per usual, a last thanks to those who thought I wouldn't make it for making me too spiteful to give up. It was about this time 1 year ago when it truly occurred to me that I was eligible to be speaking at graduation. As many of my peers can attest, I was and still am extremely competitive in all aspects, aside from physical. Because of this, it is no surprise that my competitive nature told me that my problems would suddenly disappear if I don't know, won an ambiguous title to feel accomplished. We've all been there. It's our human nature to set our goals for ourselves, put the extra effort in, and ride that motivation to success. Though success always feels great, we often find ourselves bored after 15 seconds and unsatisfied, already chasing a newer and greater goal. Don't get me wrong, setting goals for oneself is a productive and effective way to make self-improvements. What is unhealthy, however, is the expenses we take to achieve these personal goals. At the expense of a perfect GPA, I lost sleep, put friendships on the back burner, and stressed over tests, and namely, convinced myself that it was all worth it. Though this statement may speak more volumes about our education system's implementation of letter grades, it personally ties to me and the cost I took to achieve a goal I obsessed over. Sure, it's fun and all getting to wear shiny medals and publicly speak in front of a room full of mostly strangers, but what I wouldn't give to be sitting in the audience with you all today, listening to someone more deserving speak, as I look back at my years at Clintonville High School and know that my time here was full of fun teenage memories and time spent learning rather than memorizing and perfecting. Forgive me for sounding cliche, but I'm trying to say that it's time we begin enjoying the process of life instead of dropping everything small that we appreciate and love just to achieve our goals faster. We have our whole lives ahead of us. Instead of gazing directly into the future, let's for once take a moment to stop and acknowledge this moment right now. Our last 4 years have led up to us graduating on this very day, so why not recognize it? Before we rush into life, speedrunning a bachelor's degree, managerial position, or family, creating an endless cycle of dissatisfaction and goal chasing, let's prime our futures by being prepared to take things slow, not being afraid to veer away from the trail, expect and appreciate change, and simply trust the process. I believe that I can speak for most of us when I say that we are excited from the very beginning of high school for it to finally be over. We wanted to plunge into life and experience everything new and exciting and different. But if that's the case, why do we feel so emotionally conflicted in leaving? Though these past years were essentially a chorus of, "I can't wait to graduate," I can't help but notice a solemn mood in the air today, a sadness that it's over, like we're all just leaving something great behind. What happens to that good riddance attitude that we all swore would stick with us forever? Let's face it, as easy as it is to call these noisy halls a prison, this 4-year sentence is a chunk of our lives we will never forget. Our society likes to put a spotlight on ultra-successful teenagers that create unrealistic goals for ourselves. But no, we don't need to win a Nobel Peace Prize by age 17 or even be capable of filing our own taxes. We just need to be willing to at least try. That's the beauty of time. It takes time. Why rush towards milestones and goals, wasting time that could be spent enjoying life? Yes, our futures start now, but we have tomorrow and the day after that to get there. Thank you. We will now continue with the co-valedictorian address by Isaac Schultz.
First of all, congratulations to the class of 2022. I am beyond proud of all of you. Now, before I begin, I just want to give a quick shout out to my mother, who has continued to inspire me throughout these past 4 years and, well, the past 18 years of my life. And also to my principal, Kelly Zeinert, who has continued to have me strive for academic excellence, and to Mrs. Rohr, who had to put up with my annoyance, I would say, the past 3 years in English class. And also, lastly, I want to say thank you to a couple of my friends, Teresa Murphy, Carolyn Saucy, Kayla Shakowski, and Ava Arndt, for putting up with my frivolous antics these past 4 years, especially if it meant driving in a horrible thunderstorm and almost killing us just to get Starbucks. Now I begin. Welcome students, family, friends, Clintonville School Board of Education, Clintonville Superintendent Troy Kuhn, Clintonville High School Principal Kelly Zeinert, and Clintonville High School Associate Principal Brett Strahoda. Man, what a last 4 years it has been. From taking our first steps as freshmen on that dreaded yet exciting first day of high school, to our final steps as seniors as we walk across this very stage, diploma in hand. As we leave here today, the doors of opportunity open up for each and every one of us as we will all take different paths in life. Throughout each of our lives, we will all become successful in one way or another. However, in order to become successful, one must be resilient. Thank you to Julie Rohr for teaching me that. Appreciate it. And that is what I admire most about our grade, how resilient we have become since our freshman year. Especially with the COVID-19 pandemic, Clintonville High School has taught us an innumerable amount of lessons, life skills, and values, two of which are adaptability and tenacity, exemplifying our resilience. Our sophomore year, we had to adapt to isolation and a new academic instruction. Our junior year, which was filled with uncertainty, we had to adapt to attending school at home, which at least for me, was in my bed or in the mall shopping and drinking my venti iced latte. I don't know about you, but when I had my junior honors English class during first period, the first thing that I would always hear would be, "Hello and good morning, class, so great to see you," with a very big smile on her face. I am sure that I can speak for my entire English class, and that we are all still half asleep on our PJs and staring at our screens the, "Can you not look?" and thinking to ourselves, "Mrs. Rohr, why are you like this?" And I say this with the best intentions, Mrs. Rohr. With adapting to many foreign ways of alternative instruction that were scheduled with uncertainty, I would like to think that we all made it out alive, stronger than ever. I know this because of what is sitting right here before me. The constant adaptability that we experienced throughout high school will serve as a life skill in all of our bright futures, as we are already familiar with how to adapt to certain situations, especially if thrown at us abruptly. Our time at Clintonville High School has also taught us how to be a tenacious individual. When we are determined to do something, we get it done, even if it's more challenging than we thought it would be. At some points in my high school career, I questioned if completing all these assignments was really worth it, and I am certain that some of you may have as well. However, we did it, we made it, congratulations. I know for a fact that if you ever had Mr. Crumba as a teacher, which is an honor, the class would be determined to get Mr. Crumba all riled up on a completely different topic. Yes, we still learned the required curriculum, but when we got off topic, the life lessons that we had taught us is one of the greatest gifts a student at Clintonville could ask for. Also, if you had him for a teacher, the words 12-point comforta will always repeat in my mind, as he would always stress the importance of conveying our research in a formal lab report. And Mr. Crumba, I do apologize, but I will also probably forget photovoltaics because he made me build a solar-powered car and didn't warn me that the graphite loop for the axle, which I had no idea what an axle even was powder and eventually squirted all over my face due to my ignorance. Overall, the determination that we have developed will continue to inspire the class of 2022 and wherever our future endeavors may lead us. You know, I am a firm believer that everything happens for a reason. Even though COVID-19 and the virtual learning wasn't disguised as a colorful gift that would let us glide through high school with ease, it was a gift that taught us how to live and persevere through the most challenging times in life, and that it is only up to us to decide the trajectory of our lives and the success that complements it, which is why all of us will thrive and be successful in any paths we choose to pursue. Finally, I would like to make an honorable mention to the Clintonville graduating class of 2022. We have all earned this honor of graduating, as all of us have gone above and beyond these past 4 years. We have shown selflessness, determination, perseverance, on occasion sassiness, and the desire to help others. This is an accurate representation of what the Clintonville class of 2022 is all about. And it is with this that I am certain that the class that sits before me is one of the most innovative and prosperous class that the Clintonville High School has ever seen. Also, when we leave here today, I want all of you to go out and slay and be that bougie queen that you are meant to be. Yours truly, Isaac Schultz. Thank you and congratulations. And now we will hear from Abigail Schreiber, who will be delivering her salutatorian address.
It seems like yesterday, September of 2009, that we were Velcroing our light-up tennis shoes with our cute little Tinkerbell or Batman backpacks heading into our kindergarten year, so excited to start school. Now, fast forward 13 years later, and we're ready to get the heck out of here. Here we are, fellow classmates, ready to turn our tassels and take the next step into life. Here I am, welcoming all of you again for the who knows how many times today to the class of 2022 graduation ceremony. I'm honored to be up here to reminisce on all the fun memories we shared as a class throughout our years in high school. I would say that we were a pretty fun bunch and a pretty well-behaved class too, unlike the other classes. Sorry, Ms. Zeinert, wherever you are. But we're the only good class left. Good luck next year, you'll need it. But anyway, sit back and jog your memory with me. It all started in elementary school, where we met new people and made new friends. When the Scholastic Book Fair came to town, you best believe that we took each and every penny we had and spent it on bendy pencils, tiny phone erasers, and pretty much everything that wasn't a book there. We learned how to bargain by selling magazines with each other and how to cheat our way out of things by pretending to tie our shoes just so we wouldn't have to walk so much around the football field. Gym class and recess were always fun times with the colorful parachutes, little scooters, big snow hills, and the big playground at the elementary school, which us private schoolers were a little bit jealous of. There were some scary moments, like that 1.5 earthquake we had. There were some interesting moments. Does anyone remember when Braden Banky and Lizzie Walker got married? And of course, there were some embarrassing moments, like when Elian Tamayo threw up on stage. Or when someone held their breath for too long that they passed out. Andy Lamia getting pantsed by Colin Fields. Let's just say elementary school was a wild ride, but you want to know an even wilder ride? Middle school. In middle school, we connected closely with the friendships that we had previously made, or we ended those friendships and made new ones. We started to find what we were good at. We tried new things like band, sports, and clubs like Wise Guys. We went through some phases, some good, some bad, and some weird. Us girls thought that the Nike tie headbands with our receding hairlines was a look. And don't even get me started on the neon basketball shorts, knee socks, and slides that the boys used to wear and thought they were so cool. We all had our obsessions with singers like One Direction and Taylor Swift, and TV shows like iCarly, SpongeBob, and Big Time Rush, and movies like Hannah Montana, VeggieTales, High School Musical, and Camp Rock. Don't even deny it, y'all know you were once into one of those. We all thought we were in love in our romantic relationships that we swore would be forever, but really ended after a few days or weeks and made us heartbroken. We still had our love for recess, walking around the track, playing hide and seek, or having a football or basketball championship. We prepared ourselves for high school with our school spirit, winning the spirit stick every year. Our spirit was great, but our attention at the high school football games was not, as we just messed around under the bleachers. What memorable times. Oh, and let's not forget about all the fun trips we got to go on during our middle school years, like Northern Lakes. Kind of jealous that I didn't get a chance to go. Or if you went to St. Rose, the trips to Chicago, Wisconsin Dells, and Camp Tekakwitha, and the kids at St. Martin's who went to Camp Luther and Six Flags, fun times. Some teachers did some pretty memorable things too during our middle school days. Remember when Mr. Sievertson tore his Achilles heel during Hoops for Heart? Or when Mr. Dorn got hit in the face with a garbage can and had to get stitches? Oh boy. Can't forget us kids too. Remember when Magnum Mishansky slayed while singing Zompy during the eighth grade send-off? Yeah. Or when Ethan Masiarchin couldn't say octopus the right way appropriately? And lastly, the time that someone was eating hot glue sticks? Middle school was pretty crazy. But after a pretty crazy middle school ride, we ended up in high school as very awkward little freshmen. Oh, we got right into it our freshman year. Remember having to clean up after the seniors because they left dead deer in the school, or breaking into the school, left a toilet in the front of the school, and so on? Thankfully, that one didn't get canceled and rescheduled, unlike sophomore year, which did. Thanks, class of 2021, for that one. And junior year, we didn't have homecoming again. Well, thanks COVID for that. But finally, senior year, we had a decent homecoming. I mean, we did put the school up for sale and sticky note to the school, but those were good ones, nothing that would jeopardize our homecoming. And we can't forget about guys volleyball during homecoming when we won our sophomore and senior year and almost our junior year, which was definitely rigged. Do you know what else was rigged? Mr. Nigber's homeroom class always somehow winning all the homeroom competitions. Prom is always a memorable event. Caleb Christofferson and Jordan Lehman reigned as our royal king and queen. And then was our senior year, our senior year. We did some of the craziest things, like splatter gun wars. Sorry, Ms. Seinert. We traveled around the state just to watch football play. We had a lot of great athletic events, but remember that one basketball game where we had students from the high school, middle school, Iola, Bondiwell, and Shiocton fill the stands completely? That was such a fun game. We got to experience two legit unplanned fire drills, one resulting from a pizza oven that may or may not have been Mr. Schmeichel's fault. What crazy times. In all seriousness, I could spend hours and hours up here talking about all the fun, crazy, stressful, sad, and unforgettable things we did in our 13 years mostly spent together, because I know that there are so many that I miss. But I think it's important to take a few minutes and think back to those moments that I didn't mention. According to psychologists, we should view a life as a worthwhile story, not just one thing after another. Looking back, we could just think of one memory after another, but instead, our memories are a story. Your individual story and our class's story that reminds us of all the lessons learned, all the hard times we went through, the fun times, who we were in the past, who we are now, and how we came to be the people we are today, the successful students walking the stage with our diplomas in our hands. In the end, I want to thank you all, administration, friends, family, teachers, and fellow classmates. We wouldn't be the people we are today without you in our lives, for pushing us, for supporting us, and for being there. As we are about to take this next step into our lives, I hope your journey takes you long and far. I hope you remember those memories that make you happy, but go out now and make so many more new ones. This isn't the end of your story, but only the beginning. My best wishes to you all. And now the senior choir members will sing My Way.
Then again. All right, class of 2022, the moment we've all been waiting for, the awarding of the diplomas. Can I just say on behalf of the School District of Clintonville, it has really been a pleasure. Although there were a lot of stories told, we have enjoyed you as a class. You're classy, not sassy. We like that. And now for the awarding of the diplomas. As a representative of the School District of Clintonville, I hereby certify that the graduates sitting before me have met the requirements of the state of Wisconsin and the Clintonville School Board. Will the candidates for diploma please rise? Co-valedictorian and honor grad, Joseph Daniel Klemp.
Congrats.
Co-valedictorian and honor grad, Isaac Jacob Schultz.
Move down a little bit.
Salutatorian and honor grad, Abigail Nicole Schreiber. Class president and honor grad, Teresa Johanna Alma Murphy. Marissa Lynn Ader. Lara Arjona Fernandez. Ava Elizabeth Arndt, honor grad. Danielle Adriana Arneson. Samuel Donald Arneson. Jasmine Victoria Baraboo. Raja Aliyah Mo Beckett. Braden James Banky. Alexander Gerald Belfus. Reginald Joseph Moraletta Bielik. Braden Carl Brandstrom, honor grad. Cody Lewis Carrico, honor grad. Amika Chadowit. Caleb Dennis Christofferson, honor grad. Kylie Marie Clinton, honor grad. Josephine Brooke Cola. Ariana Correras. Woo! Olivia Ann Danley, honor grad. Paige Agneta Dunlovey, honor grad. Jessica Ann Dunchy. Alexander James Ecker. Nicholas Matthew Edwards. Bubba Bryson Engelhart. Tyler Thomas Ferg, honor grad. Colin Taylor Fields. Thayer Cooper Feach. Ryan Lee Jensko. Anthony Noe Gonzalez. Cheyenne Lynn Grzakowski. Alexander Otto Harbaugh. Destiny Ann Hazelrig. Riley Lawrence Heeg. McKagan Charles Huebner. Ariana Elizabeth Hunstable. Clayton Paul Jarvis. Oscar Alvaro Jimenez. Alexander Stephen Johnson. Bryson Leo Coates, honor grad. Aaliyah Rain Cable. Isabella Ray Keppen, honor grad. Desilee Elizabeth Kuhn. Andrew Allen Lamia, honor grad. Sophia Jane Lamia, honor grad. Enya Rose LeGrave. Jordan Lee Lehman, honor grad. Jacqueline Luciano. Leah Bell Lunt, honor grad. Ethan Alexander Messiarchin. Michael Magnum Mashansky III. Jonathan Munez. Megan Lily Osborne. Olivia Rose Osborne. Abby Joe Oski, honor grad. Tanner Robert Perry, honor grad. Tucker Thomas Perry, honor grad. Carson Dean Perry. Rylan Keith Pingle. Casey Lewis Plitterell. Kendra Lee Pacoit. Elizabeth Jean Poppy, honor grad. Brody James Prill, honor grad. Jacob Anthony Rogers. Cole Randall Rosno, honor grad. Kimberly Santiago, honor grad. Carolyn Ann Sassi, honor grad. Riley Jean Schertz, honor grad. Kaylee Elizabeth Schrader. Allison Ann Schweitzer. Isaiah Thomas Scotto. Hunter Charles Cerna. Kennedy Christine Skoken, honor grad. Adrian Darnell Smith. Elijah Gerald Smith. Havana Stanky. Hannah Brooke Strong, honor grad. Kayla Lynn Shikuski, honor grad. Ilian Jesus Tamayo. Elizabeth Ryan Walker. Elijah John Weber. Yeah. Jasmine Dawn Wilson, honor grad. Jesse Peter Wilson, honor grad. Joshua Mark Wilson. Hayden Stefan Winoviak. Logan Ryan Zarling. Andrew William Zeinert. Mason Gary Schechner, honor grad.
All right, class of 2022, it is with great pleasure that I ask you to turn your tassel from the right to the left, signifying that we have officially graduated from Clintonville High School. Congratulations, class of 2022. You may now leave the gymnasium.
Thank you. like a perfect night to dress up like hipsters and make fun of our exes. It feels like a perfect night for breakfast at midnight.